Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in previous video we have learned our first agenda of BJT characteristics, that is CB, CC and CE configuration of BJT. Now in this particular video we will learn the current and voltage relationship mathematical expression of BJT. As far as BJT is concerned, I know that there are three current. One is emitter current, that is expressed as IE. One is collector current, that is expressed as IC. And another is base current, that is expressed as IB. These three currents are interrelated with each other, whereas if you note that this is a particular BJT, simple BJT, as far as area is concerned, base is having very less area, collector is having very large area. As far as doping is concerned, emitter is heavily doped, collector is moderately doped, and base is lightly doped. Now with this fact, I can say that one electron is here in the majority charge carrier. If you are considering NPN transistor, then this electron is moving towards base side, right? All the electrons are already filled by these majority charge carriers, that is nothing but the holes in the P region, that is base region. So what that electron will do, few of these electrons will recombine with the holes, very less amount of current will flow through base, out of this base, right? And many electrons will enter into the collector region. So can I say that I will apply the KCL at this particular junction, and this junction I will name it as A. So I can express this complete thing in a nodal formula, that is, if electron is moving towards base and then further to collector, one of the electron is moving towards the base and forming a recombination coming out of the base terminal. So I can express this in the form of current as well, taking the opposite direction. So we can say that this is nothing but the collector terminal, this is nothing but the base terminal, where base current is flowing in opposite to the direction of the flow of electron coming out of the base. And here I can say that the direction of the emitter. Now I can say, express the equation of this IC, IE and IB in the form of IE is equal to IC plus IB. Incoming current is equal to outgoing current. So here we will be getting the first equation of relationship between emitter, collector and base current. Now we will move further. Do we have any another relationship in the form of ratio of collector and emitter terminal ka current, ratio of base and collector terminal ka current? Let's see. Now let us see first ratio, that is IC divided by IE. If you see this ratio carefully, I can say that it's nothing but the ratio of two currents. If I name these currents as output current and input current respectively, then I can also say that this turned out to be IO with respect to II. Do we have a specific namakaran for output current divided by input current? Yes, that is nothing but current gain. Gain is a factor, that is nothing but output quantity divided by input quantity. So here I can say gain is nothing but output divided by input. If that output quantity is a current, then I can say that it's a current gain. So I can also say that current gain is equal to output current divided by input current. Now you have to find out, in the previous video, just now we have studied that what is CV configuration, what is CC configuration, and what is CE configuration, where we are getting the current gain, voltage gain, right? So with this particular current gain, we are getting IC divided by IE. We are terminology we are using of current gain with respect to your IO divided by II, and we are framing this in the form of IC divided by IE. So shall I get one particular mode of operation, or we can say configuration of BJT, such that my output current is nothing but collector current and your input current is nothing but base current. If output is connected to your collector, input is connected to your emitter, then base ne kya pop kiya hai? Base is common for both collector and emitter. So I can say that common base configuration. So this is the common base configuration, where I'm getting IC as output current and IE as input current. So this particular ratio, I can name it as only one mode ka current gain, that is nothing but common base current gain. So I can name this as and this is generally denoted by alpha, right? Now I have got that alpha is equal to IC divided by IE. In another way, I can express this as IC is equal to alpha time IE. Okay, I will name this as equation number 2 so far in this particular video. Now we will go for another ratio, so that we can express this ratio and that ratio and their relationship. IC divided by IB. Again we will express this as IO divided by II. Now there is no need to write that what is current gain, what is gain, and we can write straight away that if this is the collector, I'm treating it as output current, this is base current, I'm treating it as input current. So I can easily say that there is no emitter current into picture. So emitter is common for both output as well as input. So I can say that this is turned out to be common emitter current gain, right? And this is generally expressed as beta. Now we all know that what is beta. Now beta is equal to IC divided by IB, right? We will write this as equation number 3 so far we have discussed in this video. Now we will try to combine equation number 2 and equation number 3 and equation number 1. With equation number 1, 2 and 3, can I say that, let's say from equation number 1, I am saying that IE is equal to IC plus IB, right? If we divide this by IB, right, if we divide this by IB, then I can say IE divided by IB is equal to IC upon IB plus 1, right? But from equation number 3 itself, we have got IC upon IB is what? Beta. So we'll be getting IE, I will write directly as IE is equal to beta plus 1 multiplied by IB. So here we'll be getting IB multiplied by beta plus 1. This is another relationship between emitter current and base current. Now we'll have to move further to have a relationship between alpha and beta, that is nothing but the common base current gain and common emitter current gain. See, first of all, I'm writing what is alpha. alpha is nothing but IC upon IE. What is beta? Beta is nothing but IC upon IB, right? If you try, what will be the value of alpha, which is maximum? I know that the relationship between IC and IE, IC is generally in the form of milliampere. So this is generally milliampere. IE as well in the form of milliampere. Right, whatever electrons which are moving from emitter, out of that only few will get recombined with the base, as this area and lightly doped nature of base, and many of them are moving towards the collector side. So the current IE, which is greater than IC practically as well as ideally. So I will not get the value of alpha which is greater than 1. So value of alpha, which is always and always less than 1. Ideally, this is right. Ideally, we'll be getting alpha which is very, very nearly equal to 1. Because many a times for calculation, mathematical expression, we are taking IC which is nearly same as that of your IE. Now let's coming to the part of beta. Beta is equal to IC upon IB. As I said earlier, very few emitter electron gets recombined with the holes at the base side, and base will be getting very, very less amount of electron at the base terminal. So base current is measured in the form of microampere, 10 to the power minus 6, and here IC we are taking in the form of milliampere. So if we take the ratio, which is nearly coming out to be, if IC and IB is having significant figures same. Now if we taking the same significant figure for IC as well as IB, then we'll be getting beta is equal to 1000, which is very, very high. So generally the value of beta is much, much greater than 1. So these are the specific values. If we have the value of current gain which is nearly equal to 0 point something, then you should get to know that this is the value of alpha. If we are getting the value of current gain which is nearly equal to 60 or 100 or 120 or 290, that is nothing but the value of beta. Now we will be having the relationship between alpha and beta. Let's start with this. Alpha is equal to IC upon IE. Again, coming to the part of equation number 1. From equation number 1, we'll be getting IC divided by IC plus IB, because IE is nothing but the combination of collector current and base current. What we will do, we will take the reciprocal of both sides. So we'll be getting 1 upon alpha is equal to IC plus IB divided by IC. Now with this fact, we can get to know that 1 upon alpha is equal to 1 plus IB upon IC, right? But I know that what that IB upon IC is, it's nothing but the inverse of beta. Now we'll get the everything in the form of alpha and beta, and we can easily get the relationship between alpha and beta. So we can write it over here. You can also do one thing, take a pause of 2 minutes, take this all material and start thinking about the final expression of alpha and beta and write that expression. So this is the first expression we have got. Alpha is equal to beta upon 1 plus beta, right? Can we have the value of beta in terms of alpha? Yes, obviously. We can start from the value of beta. We can write this IB as IE minus IC. Again, we'll do one thing, that is inverse of beta. Then we'll be getting 1 upon beta is equal to 1 upon alpha minus 1. We'll take this as 1 minus alpha divided by alpha is equal to 1 upon beta. And finally, we will be getting the value of beta is equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha. Which is nothing but second expression of beta in the form of alpha. Previously we have called alpha in the form of beta. So these two relationships are very, very important in your DC as well as AC analysis of BJT. So here we will stop for this particular video. We have got the current relationship of BJT. Thank you so much for watching this particular video. We will learn more and more ADC along with you, along with me, with Ekeeda videos. So for that, you have to subscribe the channel Ekeeda. Thank you.